Hello and welcome to AA's Art Channel. My name is Elke on the Instagram, and today we're going to have another look at this great tip painting that I did back in 2016. And that's because I didn't have a voiceover for this one yet, but I like to do it because I have a lot of fun stuff to share with you guys with different techniques. And maybe you have noticed I have some bit of glare here on, this because of the glass. I'm sorry for that, but this great tit is well, at least 10 times bigger than the great tit itself, but I like to for this one to expand it a bit more and to focus on those little details and have a bit more more ability to lay in those details, because it's a bigger painting, so you have that ability. But before I'm going to start the tutorial, I'd like to share with you which things, look like brushes, but they have a rubber tip on them, and I'd like to share that before I start the tutorial, because I use this one quite often for this drawing. Back then I didn't have these two. These have a little bit of different shape than this one, but I found these very, very useful if you are using pastels, pencils or sticks, it doesn't matter, or a pen pastel. These are very handy for little details and for little blendings. For example, on the head of this bird, or in the eye, where you have tiny spaces and you need to blend them, these are very, very handy, because you cannot do that with your hands, because your fingers are too big. And these things are very, very handy. So, let's start the tutorial now. And I'd like to start out with explaining why I am using different colors underneath black sections. There are a few reasons for that, because first of all, I am making the black a bit richer than when I only used it straight from the stick and didn't apply any color in with that black, because it will give you a flat black, and I like it to have it a much more richer feel. So therefore I like to include different colors. Most of the times those colors are blue, purple or red, or a reddish brown. And also it helps when you're blending your black with some blue on top of it, because it will I'm using blue on top of black to give that shiny feel, and also it helps because there's some blue underneath it, because those colors will blend in with one another, and I found it very helpful to have a little bit of blue underneath it, because it makes it more shiny. And even in real life, it doesn't appear as much in this tutorial, but in real life it makes it much richer and shiny than you see in this tutorial. But in a second you will see me apply a few lines of blue, and a quite a lighter blue, which I'm using also in the white section, because it also gives you that shiny feel there, but also on the black. And it's just a few lines, and that will give the indication of a nice shiny feathery bird, if that makes sense. But yeah, I really like that shiny part. It makes it much more realistic, and you see me doing that here. You see how nice it gives that indication of shine, and therefore I'm using a lighter blue and a darker blue, so that will make it appear much more realistic and much nicer to watch, that black. And so therefore I'm using some colors underneath that black, and later on top of that black. And here I'm doing the same process. This is a blue purplish color, and also I have straight purple and some dark blue in there. And if I apply that, then I'm starting with the black. And if I would paint this in acrylic or in oils, for example, I just would do it the other way around, because it's easier to layer some color over the black with paint and with pastels. So therefore I'm doing it the other way around with pastels. And also, like I mentioned in the intro, I'm really liking that rubber brush. I will call it a rubber brush. I don't know the exact name for it at this moment, but if you don't forget, I will have a link in the video description so you can check it out. But that rubber brush will help a lot on those teeny tiny details. And I found it so, so helpful. So I thought I need to talk about that rubber brush. It's really a handy tool to have when you're working with pastels, because you may know there are some other tools, those cotton tools, cotton blending sticks, I think they are called, and they are also some artists use them for graphic artwork. And graphite artwork, and you can use those cotton tools, but those have the tendency to pick up pastels. I know some artists use them even for the pastels, but I don't like it. I want to have the ability to control my colors on my paper. I don't want to pick them up. I just lay them in there, so I want to have them stay there, but I just want to move them around a little bit. And that is the difference between that rubber stick and that cotton blending tool. And therefore, I almost never use that cotton stick for my pastel work in the beginning, and maybe I use it here a little bit just to try it out, but I just don't like how it works. If I do any graphite, which I will do in the next couple of weeks, I think, because I ordered some, and I'm really excited about it, because I never did something in graphite, I'm so sorry, but yeah, then I will use those cotton tools just to try them out and see the difference. But yeah, like I said, for this drawing, I'm absolutely only using those rubber pencil stick things. And also for those little details, it is very important to have a sharp point on your pencils. It makes it so much easier to apply little details. And even though you may you may succeed in applying little details with not such a sharp point, you may end up with that grainy, gritty look in those teeny tiny little details. And of course, you should, you could use that rubber pencil for that to blend it in more into the paper. But if you have a sharp point, you don't have to go through all those struggles. You just have a nice little detail, a nice little pencil stroke from the beginning. Because remember, if you are blending with that blending stick, you need to blend that little teeny tiny little detail, because otherwise you will blend in some colors around that. So therefore, it may not always be that useful to only work with that rubber stick, but just for some sections use sharp pencil points. And also for the different colors, for the yellow and the green portions, I'm using quite a bit of different colors. And I'm not always using the exact colors of my reference, but I am using a lot of different colors, because that will give it a much, much more richer feel. And that is so important if you are going realistic or photorealistic. You need those colors in there just to give it a richer feeling. And also, of course, the lights and the darks, who are even more important than your colors, in mind, it will give the ability to create shapes, because this one has obviously a sort of a roundish body, and I need to get it in there. So therefore, I need I'm using quite some different colors, and once again, when there are sections who are darker, I'm making them darker, and it can look some. It may seem a little bit hard in the beginning, because I had the tendency to stick with the midtones. Don't do that. If it's dark, it is dark, and you need it to be dark. Just like this section, it's way darker than the other yellow section, because it is kept in shadows. So therefore, it will look much more realistic if you work and really watch your lights and your darks. Work on your lights and darks and watch them in your reference. And I don't know why, but I am applying the background. Yes, I do know, of course, why I'm applying a background, but I don't know why I'm doing it now, because normally I really like to start out with the background and working from the background into the front main subject. I didn't do it with this drawing. Maybe I just wanted to test it out if that was handier for me. Turned out it didn't, and I think this was the first and also the last one with the pastels that I did my background halfway through the painting. I will not do that again. I found it just way easier to start out with the background and then start with the more the upper close parts of your drawing, because I really had a hard time to fill in the space around the bird, because I those yellows and those blacks, for example, have to touch one another, to otherwise you will get that halo effect, and you don't want that, of course. But for this kind of drawings, if you like it, of course you can leave it there, but I don't like that those halo effects when I'm painting or drawing realistic, photorealistically. So therefore I need to let it get up quite close to one another. But if I blend it in a little bit too much, I smudge in that black into my yellow, and that most of the times doesn't look as nice. So therefore nowadays I just start out with the background. I found it way easier. And also those blurry effects which I'm working now in the background are helping that bird pop out way more. I'm so happy that I included that. Maybe I just thought in the beginning of this painting that I would start with a solid background. I don't know, but I changed my mind, and I'm filling in those blurry shapes, and most of the shapes are leaves, but I don't want in lay in too much of detail in that blurry background, because if I do that, of course I wouldn't have any blurry effects anymore, but also those leaves would come up way too much to the front than I want, because I want that bird in the front and not those leaves. So therefore leave them blurry if they are blurry. I don't know if you noticed, but sometimes I'm using a cotton stick in this drawing. I think also this is the last time that I'm using that with pastels. I just noticed that, but it's going very quickly, so I don't know if you can see that, but yeah, I'm using more often than not that a rubber stick. And for the bigger portions, I just like to use my hands, my fingers. I like to blend in with my fingers. If you don't like that, now you know there are tools for it, but yeah, for the bigger portions, I really like using my hands. I don't mind having pastels on my hands. So, yeah. It can get messy, of course, if you have it on your hands. But like I said, I don't mind it. I'm just washing my hands after I'm working it. And that is all. It really goes away very quickly when applied with water. So, and some soap, of course. But, yeah. And also on this branch where the bird is sitting on, I'm using quite a lot of different colors. And for this branch, I started out with a lighter color than I will end up, and that is because it will give me that shiny effect on that leaf, or it will make it easier to make that. So that is how I have to say it, because of course it will not give it from itself. If you only have a lighter color and you put a darker color over that, it will not give that shiny, but when you start to blend, it will pick up that on the layer, and it will help you to get that nice shiny feel to the branch. And I just have a hint of shiny feel on this branch, because once again I didn't want to let it stand out too much, but I just wanted a hint of that that shine on that branch. And also when I'm making texture like this on branches, I am not applying it not as it shows up in my reference photo. I'm not completely copying my reference photo, but I'm just watching those shapes and try to give the indication of those shapes. So I'm not counting how many points of how many of this and that is on my branch. I'm just copying the shape to give that feel of that roughness of that branch. And this is also a nice example when I worked on these feet and his toes. Really used pencils with sharp points, even though you cannot see it now. I think it's going too quickly, but I worked with very sharp points, and also that rubber stick to blend out some areas. And also I'm working with green, because it has a lot of green in the background. Also the branch is green, but the leaves are green. He has some green on his body, so therefore there had to be some green on his toes again to get it a complete artwork feeling, if that makes sense. If I didn't do that, those feet would stand out way too much, and it would like that those wouldn't fit in the drawing. So therefore I had to grab some green and put it in there, and now it feels like a one portion of that artwork. And I really like making those teeny tiny little details, because they add so much more to your drawing and paintings. It may not seem like that when you're starting with the painting, but if you facing the end of the paintings, those little details really take your time to fill those in, to apply those in your drawings and paintings, because it will make it so much more realistic, and there's so much more to watch for the viewers who will will watch your artwork. There's so much more to see, so therefore I like to spend quite some time on those details. Little shiny parts, I'm using just the straight white pencil, and I can use that straight white pencil because I have some colors underneath that, so it will mix in. I don't have very hard white or plain white, how you want to call it, but it will mix up a little bit more with the colors around it, so therefore it looks more naturally than just straight white. And I'm filling even up a little bit more of that blurry effect in background, and that I'm glad I did it because I like it even more, and now it feels more balanced. A little touch of shine there, and that's what I talked about in the beginning. It's so nice to blend with pastels, it's so easy, it's so nice. I really like working with this medium. And this is the photo of the end result. I hope you like it, and once again, take a look at that blue on top of his head. It gives a really, really nice shiny effect, and that is why, once again, I applied the black like I explained this in this tutorial. I did the same thing on his feathers and on his tail feathers. You also see a hint of blue there. That is just because I did those layers with those black and other colors, and then a hint of blue on top of that. So back when I started drawing and painting, I started with pastels. I found them easy to begin with, even though you are not making your best art, of course, in the beginning, but they are very friendly to start with, because you can make such a beautiful color transitions in your drawings, and I really fell in love with them when I started using them. And I didn't have anything planned out back then when I started in pastels, of being an artist or being an artist next to my daily job, which I'm doing now. But it was just amazing how easily you can blend with this. So if you are starting out in, you want to start out in art, or you know somebody who is starting out, I really would suggest starting out with pastels, because they are kind of forgiving, even though erasing is very hard. But if you have the right paper, you can layer over them. So thereby, of course, it's very hard to make something you have make black, make white again. And I think it's almost impossible, but you can make some transitions in black to going, for example, to a dark brown or a dark reddish color, or basically anything, it's possible. So if you are not completely on track on your drawing, you can easily adjust that with pastel. So therefore, it's if you ask me, very forgiving, and you can make a lot of nice art with pastels. You can, you can make everything, but so pastels is why I started become an artist, and to try out other things, because I've learned so much about lights and darks, and because it's quite easy in pastels, if like I said, if you ask me, of course. But yeah, I really, really like it. So I had to share this one, and I really want to make more art with pastels, of course. So I'm gonna make a lot of more that, and I hope you like it. So thank you for watching for now. I hope to see you at one of my other tutorials, of course. And if you like, you can follow me on Facebook, Instagram, and on my own website. This guy is also there. Basically all my artwork nowadays I post over on my website. So if you are curious of other artwork, please be welcome at my website. And also, if you like, please subscribe to my channel. I really like that.
And I have a few new subscribers, so thank you for being here. I really appreciate it. I am, while I'm recording it, at around 150 subscribers. That may not seem much in comparison to other channels, but for me it's really, really much. It feels really as my work is appreciated by you guys, so thank you very, very much for that. And also, of course, if you like this tutorial, please give it a thumbs up. And for now, thank you for watching once again, and I hope to see you at one of my next tutorials. Bye-bye!